Hi everyone and welcome back. So in this video we are going to talk about DMN tables also. So this is how the DMN table looks like. Like I created a simple DMN table. What it is saying is if my username and password is coming in these strings, I will just set logged in variable with a true. That is a boolean. Okay. So what I'm going to do here is I will create a task and I will assign the DMN table to it. Here I have added a DMN table which I already have, and this is the DMN table reference auth check, and the same reference I have added to this DMN table which is auth check. Okay, that is the configuration you have to do while doing the binding. Implementation is DMN table, the DMN table ID and the binding latest. Okay, and the result variable from this DMN table we are storing in the login variable. So if username and password is we are passing based on this particular table, then whatever the output we are getting, that should be stored inside a login variable as a true and false. Okay, so what we will do here is, now how should we populate this username and password? Either you have this as a service task, okay, and what you can do is you can set these variables while doing the implementation as an external task. Here you define the topic for this, and from there you set these two variables, username and password. But here this is a user task. So what we are saying is when we are deploying this, either there while starting this process, we can set username and password, or this is a user task. So while completing this, we can populate username and password. So we will take two different scenarios. First, we will populate username and password random, and then we will see the logged in value. Okay, and this is a different thing. This is, I'm just talking about the service task and the topics. These are the three different service tasks, and both all are having the topics. And we already have Kamunda client task.js, which is listening to these topics and helping us to get the variables and set the process variables. Okay, first let's talk about this. So I have already deployed this. This is this DMN table, deploy that, and all these three, let's deploy. And now we are going to talk about user auth. This is the first VPMN we have deployed. So we go to here, we can start the process. So there are different ways. This is a user auth. So while starting the process, you can set the variable username, string something blah blah, and there is another thing which is password type string something else. We are not setting the correct one. Now start this. Now go to the cockpit and see this where it is. It should stop at the user task. Well, running definition user auth, and here we can see this particular task is available here, and we can also see the process variables, which is whatever we have passed the values, right? Now if I try to complete this, I can complete this, and now it will go to the DMN table. So to complete this, this is a user task, click on to this and claim this one. I'm just doing a claim and complete. We don't need to add a variable because username and password already variables are available while starting this process. Now 12 process definitions, user auth, and now we can see this is the fifth one, the latest one, which is also available now. And here we can see the process variable login is null because we didn't find a match, so we are getting null. Right, you can complete this user task, but this is the behavior. Let's see if we are passing the correct username and password while completing this user task. So we can do this while starting the process. Let's say we are not defining those variables while starting the process, but while completing the first user task, we can pass both the variable username and password. So these are our process definition, user auth. And before completing this user task, we will populate the variable. This is a user task, and we'll complete this with the username and password. Okay, here we are, we'll claim it, and here we can add variable. So I'm saying username, and based on the DMN table, username should be test1, and add another variable, password type string. That should be of value test 3. You can check the DMN table, test 1 and test 3. And then complete this. Now go to your cockpit, see the top, see the processes. And here we'll go to user auth. Now we can see the latest. It will also has reached to this user login. And if we just see this one, the latest one, and here we can see the login is very boolean and it is value true. That's it. So whatever we wanted to achieve through the DMN table, that is achieved. We have defined some rules based on the username password and returning the output variable, which we are storing in the login variable. Here we are storing that in the login, that is of type boolean. Now you can actually navigate to you can define a gateway. In the gateway, you can check, okay, if login is true, login is false, do this, do that. So this is a simple DMN use case I'm trying to put. And here we have the service task. And we are already listening to these service tasks here. These are simple examples. What you can do is, this is the same client example which we have already discussed. I'm listening to the save database, send email and done. Right? So here if you see, save database, send email and done. What we need is, we need to populate username and password before starting this process. So because we are printing this username and password, first name and email most of the places, so we can populate these values while starting this process. So we can go to cockpit and say, okay, start this process and populate these two values. When we are hitting it from the postman, we can start the process with the process variable. And this is also another way, from the task list you can start the process you want. Okay, here we can start process. And we are starting process create user, and we can also specify variables. So first variable is a first name, and that is of type string. It is TKS Sharma, first name, and the email, that is of type string. Okay, and start this. Now we might be already listening this. So we can see all the variables are getting populated. All the three tasks are completed. First is save to database, completed task. Then it is polling, send email. We got the first name email. Then done, send email and first name. So throughout this listening process, we can set, we can get the variables, which we have already seen in the previous example. We were actually creating the new variables and setting these new variables while completing this task. Similarly, these are the three new topics we have created: done, send email, and create user. So you can do all different kind of async tasks, like saving it to the actual database, doing some processing, and then mark the task complete. Send email. You can get the variables, you can set the variables, do your stuff, sending the email asynchronously, task is done, or populate the new variables, right? So this is the whole objective of this video, is talking about the DMN tables and service tasks and handling them through the external topics. Okay, thanks everyone.